Hi, Geoff here, and I'm in a village called Misfah, and it's high up in the mountains in East Oman, past Muscat. And we're in an old food forest village, date palm, overstory, subtropics. It's kind of partly dismantled, partly abandoned, but kind of coming back to tourism a little bit. I'm not sure how long it will last, but it's got some interesting water system, interesting Falaj, it's kind of stick terraces. And we're going to go for a walk around and show you what's about. It's pretty fascinating stuff.
Here's the watering system coming out of the main spring up in the mountain. But there's also a little bit of modernization. We've got a plumbing pipe adaption from one Falaj, the name of the watering system. Falaj is dropping through the pipe underneath the crack, which has been concreted in modern times, and going down the drain here with a little steel grill. So, they're modern adaptions. Terraced gardens with tomatoes cascading off the edge. So, doing pretty well actually. And I risk climbing up here. Pretty good looking tomatoes in there. Oh, and we've got lettuces up the top and blue pea. And I can see some onions on the next terrace above me and tomatoes creeping over the wall up there. It's all a bit steep to be climbing around with a camera though. Pomegranate here, hanging over the wall. Mango, just starting to fruit. Cooking banana. And over the top of the canopy in the background, a really big mango. There's a bit of wild habitat. I found a few frogs. Obviously, they're living in the water system. Little steps and water channels going everywhere, leading to almost like secret terraces all through the system. It's quite a beautiful thing to walk around, actually. We have rock towers on the ridge next to the village, which we use to time the watering system in and around the movement of the stars. And they're still there. And of course, they'd still work. Stars are still there too. Some of the original walls have all been mortared together with mud. So mud and straw mortar holding these rocks together, and then here and there they've been patched up with cement, but the originals are still here. Maybe some of the skills have gone. There's a little citrus hanging over the top of this wall, but it's a traditional wall held together with mud and straw render mortar, should I say, mud and straw mortar. Here we are, more frogs. They're definitely in the watering system, these little guys. At the end of the water channel coming into the main village, there's a distribution pond. So it's all set up to release water into the systems around the main gardens. So we're releasing water at different places, at different times. Then when she's just about to release water, or to block water, there we go. We let some go. It's a complex system. But this is a storage pond, which is also used for bathing, right on the edge of the village. And there's a certain amount of water here is released at a certain time of day, right from the bottom. So the bottom of the system has a stone that releases the water into the village, into this area close by the houses. And there we go. We just released some. Now there are steps here. So the underwater steps, which are actually timed at 1 hour's release for one step. So there's some forage coming in. Part of the system is put into forage, that's alfalfa, to feed the animals, which provide the manure as the fertilizer. And there's, at this time of day, there's forage coming in for the animals. And there's a water release point happening right now. And water's coming past into this channel and down into that release. And then we've got, I think there's more water release going on down the bottom. Off it goes. Change of irrigation. And a nice little storage facility high up in the system, which has multi-functions. Has a bathing pool and nutrient distribution system. There's a couple of really nice mangoes here hanging off the edge of a terrace. Beautiful stuff. Here we have the tadpoles. Plenty of new frogs coming through by the look of it. Oh. Actually, these are fish. Here we have little fish in the irrigation system. Yep. This is the main channel. And the water is distributed from this channel out through the system. And this water goes to all the village in every area. So we have a equally distributed water, and different areas get a certain amount of water over time, day and night. There are a few figs here and there, growing off the thermal mass of the heat of the wall, helping them dry out a bit. And we have a lot of forage grass, which is getting regularly cut for the animals in amongst the system. The animals are providing the manure, so it's a return upcycle, grass to manure. More mangoes. Here on one of the terraces, it becomes quite obvious what the fertilizer is. And that's goat manure. Plenty of it, spread over almost like a mulch. And here's a little modern adaption, a small Honda rotary hoe. So times are changing, but the fertilizer's not changing much. Composting the organic matter with this manure and make it last a lot longer. So that'll be interesting to introduce. We could definitely diversify this system and extend the fertility with many different methods of growing high carbon compost ingredients to extend the fertility of the manure systems. Green, brown, manure, it's all here. We're heading up now to the head of the spring. Obviously, you can see the system finishes somewhere in front of us. And I can hear a lot of water because it's being directed down probably another channel. And the sun's not quite over into the wadi yet, so it's quite pleasant in here right now. Not too hot. And this is obviously why the system's here, because the source of water And everything is built from the source of water. So water first, and then access, and then structural positions. So yeah, it's pretty obvious, no brainer really. And that's what we teach, but that's what's been the standard system in ancient times before we were overloaded with technology. And here we've got a block. That's the water I could hear. So blocked with rocks and old clothes and cloths. And right now, there's a redirection going that way. So this part of the system is getting its concession. Blocked off coming this way. Blocked off going that way. Being allowed to go straight down here. And over it goes. Mangoes, date palms, fruit trees, vegetable gardens, all getting their concession. I've got one of the local workers here blocking off the section. Direct water down to one of the gardens. Two levels of water here, main canal and lower distribution channel. And all the trees have been well watered just below. There's just a partial break here. That's a subtlety of block there, allowing some water past, slowing this water down, backing it up a bit, and then letting the sediment mount out. When you look over the wall at the wadi, you can see the flow of water just here. You can see the debris on the bushes. There's massive water come through sometimes. And you can see it held up in the trees. So if we step back into this channel here, I'm back inside over the wall now. You can see they've made modern adaptions to handle the flood. And they put in pipes. And they put pipes all the way along this little section here before the first concrete barrage wall. So when the water gets too much for the irrigation canal, it goes out sideways into the wadi. So they've put in this release point. Modern changes to maybe changing climate or just a new adaption. Things can always be refined and improved. And it just handles that step in level there. Means the water would go out through these pipes and take the pressure off the canal and the channel and send it down this main wadi, which is a pretty rugged system. And here's the water in the wadi. And the water you can hear behind me is being siphoned from a pool above the source of the spring. So that's a siphon pipe, another modern adaption using a poly pipe, irrigation pipe. And we're just about at the source now. This is where they've caved in a bit to the hill and pulled the water. Got quite a shoal of fish coming up underneath, you see. And the water comes from somewhere. Oh, more frogs. somewhere up in here. Yep. Well, I'm not going in there, but somewhere up in there, they tunneled in and got the source of the water, which started this whole system.